and MJ Akbar, Junior Minister of External Affairs, has resigned, but the court battle for his defamation suit begins today. The case will come up in Delhi's Patiala High Court, and that Akbar's resignation is the first high-profile exit in the Me Too movement, but he still remains to be a BJP MP, and party sources say he will remain that. In his resignation, he said, "Since I have decided to seek justice in court of law in my personal capacity, I deem it appropriate to step down from office and challenge false accusations leveled against me also in a personal capacity." Now, Priya Ramani, who was the first woman who called out on Akbar, has welcomed the step, and she hopes to get justice in court, is what she tweeted in her first reaction. Now, interestingly, Akbar has sued one of the 20 accusers of defamation, alleging a conspiracy of harm to his reputation. Today, he has a battery of lawyers to make his case in Patiala House Court. All right, we are joined by reporters now. Sukirti joining us live from outside MJ Akbar's house. Sukirti, the house plate will still say Junior Minister of Home of External Affairs, but that not his designation anymore. The Me Too movement has had its first high-profile exit. Any activity around the house? Have you had lawyers come in? What are you hearing from BJP sources on the further course of action now?
From the BJP sources, what we are hearing at this point of time is that this resignation was entirely MJ Akbar's decision. There was no pressure from the party to resign. From the very time that the allegations started coming in, the sources in the BJP said that the BJP wanted to look into the depth of the allegations. These were some of the words that we kept hearing, because they felt that this could be a motivated attack. This could be coming from certain sections, from the left liberal sections of the society. So that's why they did not think that there was too much into the allegations. And even after they did come in, and even then, they were very suspicious of the veracity of the allegations. The other thing that the BJP did not want was this to set a precedent that tomorrow women could come up, level allegations against some other BJP leader, and then BJP would be forced to ask that minister as well to resign. So BJP from its side did not want to set a pattern in place, and that is why the entire party kept refraining from making any comments in the entire case, including many of the female ministers. We did hear Smriti Irani and the others make subtle comments on it, but nobody came out openly or strongly to make comments against Akbar. On the other hand, the perspective that MJ Akbar could have possibly had in this case was that he was thinking that once he files this defamation suit, the voices would be silenced. However, the opposite happened. Once he filed the defamation suit on Monday, after that, the voices only grew louder. There were more women who came, who started raising their voice about what had happened to them in the 1990s while they worked at Asian Age. And all of these women said that they would come to court and testify for Priya Ramani against MJ Akbar, which was completely contrary to what MJ Akbar was expecting, that once a legal defamation suit comes into the picture, people would get scared and people would be silenced. However, their voices on the social media also grew louder. People said that people would want to fight pro bono for her. There were others who said that a fund should be set up to help the legal cost that Priya Ramani would have to face. And the third factor here is also the number of months or the years for which this case could continue. When we spoke to people and many of the legal experts, they said that this is just the beginning of the case. Today the hearing would start. First, the court will have to take cognizance of the case. After that, Akbar would have to bring his witnesses, prove his testimony in the upcoming hearings, and then Priya Ramani's side would be called in, and this entire process could take months and months. And the media will continue to highlight every hearing, and MJ Akbar's name would come up every time, which would bring a lot of bad and negative attention on him. And that is why he decided that for him to continue as a minister would prove harmful to his reputation further.